What's up, you filthy heretics? How are you doing? My name is Asmagon, and today we'll be talking about the most legendarily popular fan-favorite sub-faction and culture in the 40k universe. Some would even say these iconic combatants epitomize 40k itself. Yes, of course, I'm talking about our favorite suicidal gas mask-wearing sociopaths, the Death Corps of Krieg. So, without further ado, on with the lore dump. The prosperous hive world of Krieg during the mid-40th millennium, and yes, I do mean 40th, not 41st. Don't actually me, you nerdy heretics. Krieg during this time was a bustling trading and manufacturing power in its sector, the would-be envy of many a hive throughout the Imperium of Man. If, of course, Krieg wasn't already so insular. Krieg was ruled by a council of autocrats at this time, each presumably ruling over different regions and levels of the planet. And the autocrats one day, while sitting around a table and doing as much cocaine as they possibly could, one of them stood up and said,
"You know what? Fuck the Emperor, and fuck the Imperium."
And the rest finished their last lines and cheered. All jokes aside, the Council of Autocrats had grown exceedingly tired of the Imperial Tithe, which required them to supply the Greater Imperium with weapons, armor, and other goods and sundries. Even though their world was immensely prosperous regardless of the Tithe, it was a thorn in the Autocrats' side to have even a sampling of their resources taken away for what they viewed as little to no benefit to themselves or Krieg as a whole. Therefore, the Council's lead autocrat, declared Krieg's independence from the Imperium, and to afford all credit where it is due, the autocrats did think this decision through somewhat. First of all, Krieg was extremely far removed from any nearby Imperial worlds. Additionally, their self-contained economy and resource production was so excellent they had more than enough to sustain themselves and the people of Krieg for potentially over a millennia. So there was plenty of logic behind the decision to secede, and may have even worked out in the long run. If what happened hadn't happened, that is. You see, there was an Imperial Guard regiment native to Krieg, which was led by Colonel Yurtin, the shabbiest of them all, some would say. The Colonel was a devout believer of the Emperor and a loyal retainer to the Imperium. Thus, when the High Autocrat declared independence by mooning the Emperor, the Colonel said,
"No,"
and led a rebellion against the Rebellion of the Imperium. Ah, I love this shit. Well, anyway, the Colonel, despite his title of Chaddiest of the Chads, could not hope to defeat the autocrats with his measly few guardsmen, and thus moved instant transmission levels of fast to take control of the hive city nearest to him in the hopes of establishing a fortified position in which he and his men could hold out until the Imperium could send in reinforcements. However, when Yurtin gave the Segmentum command a ring-a-ding for aid, they merely responded by saying that in no uncertain terms, it wasn't worth the effort, and that he was to, by any means necessary, defeat and punish the treasonous autocrats. When Yurtin asked the magic question of fucking how, he was sent a magical set of numbers that just so happened to resemble launch codes. Well, because they were launch codes. Now you may be asking yourself, launch codes? To what? Some kind of alien device which sends a shockwave of energy across the planet, with the exception of those in the Hive City? Or some really cool Age of Sigmar nukes? It was just straight up nukes, like our kind of nukes, just a lot of them. Enough of them, in fact, to leave the entire surface of the planet a nuclear wasteland.
"You can't say nuclear, that really scares me."
Now some of you may be thinking, no way in hell Yurtin would resort to destroying the whole planet just because the autocrats committed heresy by mooning the Emperor and the Imperium. And if you thought something along those lines, all I have to say is, welcome to 40k. So the good Colonel launched the nukes, and Krieg was turned into a mass of irradiated rock. After the dust settled, Colonel Yurtin and his loyalist forces were now equal to the minuscule numbers of turncoats, and both sides went subterranean to avoid the lethal levels of radiation on the surface. And before you ask, no, the surface of the planet being a lethally irradiated wasteland was not enough to stop the loyalists and separatists from waging war against each other. Fast forward over 500 years of gas masks, memes, and trench warfare, and the Segmentum Command received a communication from Krieg that is roughly summarized thusly.
"Hi, we're alive."
By we, do you mean the Loyalists or Separatists?
"Loyalists, of course."
"Neat."
We want to rejoin the Imperium.
What is it you have to offer the Imperium?
Meat shields that can hold a gun steady.
All right, we'll take a couple regiments worth.
We have over 20 ready.
What did you say?
We have over 20 regiments eager to die.
Don't you mean fight?
Yes, that's what I said.
Thenceforth, the Imperium welcomed the revolving door of fresh meat shields who were not afraid to die for a change. Now this is where the backstory of Krieg ends. However, I want to throw out a few extra details about the Death Corps of Krieg. Firstly, the gas masks are not for aesthetics, even on worlds without radiation or other harmful toxins. Krieg guardsmen are trained from early childhood that their suits and masks are to be a second skin, and this is no metaphor to them. Additionally, Krieg culture over the course of the 500 years they were at war with the traitors evolved into a hyper-regimented militaristic society which believes in the Emperor and Imperium on an immensely zealous level. Think of the most hardcore fanatic you can think of and multiply them by a million, and you'll have a near approximation of the level of zealotry Krieg guardsmen are at. Krieg guardsmen are so fanatical that literally all of them want to die. This is because of the guilt they feel for their world having turned on the God Emperor and his Imperium. And to repent, they must die in service to both the Emperor and his Imperium, and that nothing short of that martyrdom will be enough to amend their guilt of being born of the treasonous world of Krieg. Seriously, I can't stress this enough. The job of a fucking commissar, you know the guys responsible for making sure guardsmen keep in line and don't run away from the battle? Well, amongst a Krieg regiment, a commissar's job is to prevent the guardsmen from running at the enemy in an attempt to die in service to the Emperor. Hell, commissars have been killed by Krieg guardsmen for trying to prevent them from committing insane acts of martyrdom in the name of the Emperor. Well, the last thing I'll note about Krieg is that they are one of the few regiments which are allowed to artificially produce more guardsmen with the use of vitae wombs, which is a technique of some sort developed by the Mechanicum of Mars. A video on them soon. Anyway, that's it for me, you filthy heretics. I don't know how often I'll be producing 40k in a nutshell videos. That will be in large part dependent on how well they do. So remember to like, leave a comment, subscribe, and share these around. Do so for the Imperium, my brothers.